Outlook 2016 is a great email client, but many people fail to realize that it has more uses than just sending and receiving emails. These four little icons in the bottom left-hand corner are often overlooked, but they're the key to unlocking those uses. The first unlocks the calendar. We'll cover that in another video. The next is for the email client. The third will open up your contacts database. Again, there's a lot here to explore in another video. And the fourth, which we'll look at in detail in this video, opens the task list. A task list is really just another name for a to-do list with a few extra bells and whistles. We've got only one task in the list at the moment, to build a task list. To create a new task, you can either click here, or to open a new task window, let's click here, the icon for a new task. This opens up the new task window, and we'll create the new task to update our accounts. Like many tasks, I don't really care when it started, but I do want it completed by Friday the 21st of April. So I'm going to give it a high priority, which moves it up the list. And I'm going to give myself a reminder that the task needs doing. I'll remind myself on the previous Monday, which gives me 5 days to get the job done. I can add more details if I need them, but frankly, the less time I spend on the list, the more time I can devote to getting the jobs done, so I'll leave that alone. I can also delegate the task to someone else on my contact list if I want. Jonathan might be a good candidate. But delegating a task by sending an email isn't really very good management practice, so I'll leave this one alone as well. There are other options. I can send a status report to any of my contacts, or perhaps more usefully, I can set the task to recur every Friday. Because I dislike the job of updating my accounts, it's probably a good idea to remind myself to do this every week. And there it is, my new task, happily prioritized in my task list. One other useful feature is the category feature. I can name a category, in this case, finance, and give it a color. That way, I can group tasks together by their categories, such as work, family, sports, and so on. Once the task is completed, I can either delete it or cross it out. It can be good to see a list of completed tasks all crossed out, but it can also clutter up your list. So I'll delete it when it's done. And there it is, how to create a task list in Outlook 2016. eTop Technology. We're here to help. If you like these videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you found this video helpful, check out some of our more recent videos. And if you're looking for a new IT partner, please visit our website.